Hey, future cast of Spamalot watching this DVD in the future, I'm Alex Schmidt. I just want to say I love you very much, and I hope you're doing amazing things in the world and in your life. Have a great day.
Production work on this. Producer would be my official title, and it's what I do because I originally I worked in theater. I got my degree in theater. I did theater all through high school, and when I actually worked professionally in theater, I realized that I felt a little disconnected to it working in theater management, and I thoroughly enjoyed my time working on theater in high school. So I thought, well, what can I do to sort of get back in that same position? Because it was really kind of, when paying bills aren't on the line, it's a much more enjoyable art when you actually have to make sure that your lights stay on because you're acting enough. It could lose a lot of its luster. So the time that I really remember that being the most relevant was in high school. So I got an education. I got my cert. In Pennsylvania, if you want, in a lot of the schools, at least in southeastern Pennsylvania, if you want to teach theater, you teach English and then you do a little bit of theater on the side. So I end up getting certified in communications, which lets me teach English and theater. And once I got over here to Downingtown, I was fortunate enough that met up with John McGraw. He wanted to do all the artistic side. He's more of the performance guy. He's more of the directorial vision, the artistic vision, and I'm more of the business guy and the tech guy, and so we really fit in on those two sides, and we collaborate a lot, but in the end it's he's got the final say on what is going to happen artistically and how lines are going to be delivered, and I try to provide the structure for how that works. I pay the bills and provide the technician and the staff so that everything gets costumed and heard and et cetera, like that.
We'll be right back. What are your feelings for the audience?
For this art, it's really hard to express what you're actually feeling. So, I can't tell you.
I'm hyped. I'm always hyped.
No chill.
I'm feeling good. Nervous. Good. Nervous.
I just kind of want to forget everything that I've ever learned and then just remember it as I walk into the room.
Yeah, I'm doing my role as King Arthur of Camelot.
I feel pretty good. You know, I know the stuff, I practice. Caolan's here, and Rob's here. It's gonna go great. What could go wrong?
Good day, Paul.
Great day.
Good day.
Probably. Yeah.
For an audition, I have a playlist of rap music, like ghetto rap. Like, when I say ghetto, I'm talking like, if you know who ASAP Ferg is, you know who ASAP Ferg is. Because I love ASAP Ferg. If you know who ASAP Ferg is, that's that stuff I listen to. Young Thug is everywhere.
Hold on, let me swallow
it. Yeah, no, I never drink honey. I think that's the stupidest thing in the world. Like, who drinks? Honey just like clogs my throat, so I pretty much take a sip of water and then I sing.
Well, it keeps your vocal cords. Yeah. So you don't get all dry and stuff.
5, 6, 7, 8, and fall.
How are you feeling after the first lesson thing?
Well, I'm feeling pretty good. I love dancing. Dancing is my thing, man. I dance every day. I don't actually. I just completely made that up. But yeah, it's dancing. It is what it is. I'm going to do my best. Always do your best. Remember that, children. Always do your best.
Do you have a signature dance move? And if so, can you demonstrate?
I can't top that.
I'm just freestyling at that point. Yeah, I can go on for hours, but that's for you, Dad.
Do this.
Woo!
Oh, snap.
Zero carries.
Please do not put any of that in.
Hey guys, pure anus? We're like pure anus.
I just found out we did weightlift!
Excuse me, it's already you. Shut up.
Oh, okay.
God. What are you thinking? Ours, not yours. Hear that? Yeah, I don't. Oh, don't look at that camera. That is. He's looking at us. Looking at us. I see you. Listen, this guy, my best friend, I've known him since a long time. Not really that long, but a long time. He means a lot to me. Just, you know, we have a great relationship. It's a great day. It's great. It's great, right? Right? Yeah. Bye, buddy.
We're working on the dance. As you see? It's all. Very cramped time. Everybody's rushing to get it in. But I think we got it. I think overall, we took enough time. I'm confident for everyone.
Awesome.
His name is Lancelot. And in tight pants a lot. He likes to dance a lot. You know you do.
I do.
So just say thanks a lot. And my romance is hot.
Dream, no one would ever know that this outrageous
kind. Don't be shy.
Will you save your best friend from a life of crushing disappointment and defeat, yes or no? Take that silence as a yes.
What role are you trying to get?
Normally, I go into these things like incredibly open-minded. I'll take any part I get, always, basically. But this year, I'm actually really interested in King Arthur. I feel like my talents are particularly suited to it, mainly because I have a deep voice. But we'll see what happens. Regardless of the outcome, I'm super psyched for the show.
Lancelot. Why? Because he's gay. Am I gay? No. But do I want to play someone gay? Yes. Because it's fun.
Don't tell McGraw this. Haven't rehearsed it that much. Kind of winging it. But I think it'll go good.
And he wants the lead in the show.
Yes. Clearly.
I think it's going to go. I don't know. I can't wink real well. But this means it's going to go good. In my opinion. I've practiced today a few times, and I found it last night.
I feel like that's a senior thing, like no one practices.
Maybe it is a senior thing. Seniors, try a little harder, because you don't want to end up homeless like I probably will. Love you, Downingtown.
Love you!
So, I'm just gonna put it in simple words for you. I would honestly not be surprised if they made Lady of the Lake drag, and I was that drag Lady of the Lake. Now, I'm not thinking gay Lady of the Lake boy form. I'm thinking boy as girl in drag. Right? I mean, what's wrong with that? So, Mr. McGraw, this is for you. That should happen.
Yes, Ben Day. Come in, please.
Benny D?
Benny D, come in, sir.
Daddy Goo?
Hey.
Hey.
It's me again.
I love you.
Love you too. I'm really stuck at winking. Love you, Daddy.
Did you want?
Okay. I guess. So, alright. Do you think that would be able to be pulled off, Brandon?
I mean, I can be a girl if really needed. I mean, honestly, I can grow my hair out to like here, and then we don't even need to get a wig. We're saving costs by making me drag Lady of the Lake. It's without a doubt a great idea.
There you go, Brandon Carcella, everybody.
Thank you. See you later. Bye.
Let me take you on a journey. A journey through time and space. Where only man and women cannot even conceive what they are seeing.
Hey! Hey!
Oh, hello!
I didn't see you there, man.
My name's Brandon.
Are you ready?
I'm number 51.
Are you ready for the auditions?
I'm ready.
Oh,
okay.
That's
incredible. Are you auditioning? Did you get a call back?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't even know. I'm horrible with names. What's your name?
Hey, okay. Alameo.
Nice to meet
Wait.
You.
Oh, you're Kyle? Oh, hi, Kyle.
Hello. Nice to meet
My
you.
My name is Elder Price, and I would like to tell you.
I will give you a couple more minutes to do some warm-up stretching, whatever you need, and then we'll start. Okay? So just take a couple minutes, get really warmed up.
Do it again, it felt good. I like pain, not too hard. Ow, 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 ah! Pulling tendons over here.
What's up, man? How you doing?
We're gonna watch my foot break on camera, everybody.
Yes!
Welcome to Ridiculousness. I'm Rob Bolz and I'm breaking my foot. If you haven't seen that show, go watch it. I'm pretty sure that this film reel is going to be good.
Left, right, left, right, and
I'm not.
So, what did you think of your dancing tonight?
I mean, if you call what I do dancing, then pretty good, I guess.
Yeah. So, think you'll get a good part?
I mean, I hope so, but I mean, I don't know, to be honest.
Give the audience a grin. Enjoy it. It's your last chance anyhow.
Were you distracted?
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, my gosh.
Always look on the bright side of death.
You were literally just about to ask me, what did you think about that?
Life's a piece of shit.
With the art of dancing,
I'm sorry, do you feel like...
It's really...
What's the word?
It's really tough.
I don't either.
I don't know, you know?
We're like friends.
You should.
All right, Kyle?
So,
like with dancing, like it's like when you, well, it's like it's just an art form where,
yeah, I guess.
Like,
not encouraging anything.
I don't know. You know?
Oh yeah.
Well, as the pit orchestra director, my job includes organizing students, scheduling rehearsals, reading through the music, preparing for performing with the vocalists, and conducting while performing.
So, as a pit, our main goal is to just stay together and guide the singers and the actors on stage, I suppose, and to keep our dynamics in a comfortable range so that we don't overpower nor underpower the lights when we appear. And generally staying together being a musical like performance as opposed to just playing songs.
Music's coming together great. I think we've been running it for like 2.5 weeks now, and so it's really coming together. It's finally sounding like a show.
I think the most rewarding aspect is seeing the students at the end of the performances, mm-hmm. How excited they are after getting standing ovations from hundreds of people.
It adds like a kind of depth to the show by breaking the fourth wall and kind of involving the pit. So you see that when Nate gets shot, and then also when King Arthur slaps Adam in the head for hitting the symbol.
Feel pretty good. Feel like Lee Harvey Oswald. I just wish there was a second shooter.
I'm pumped about a bunch of things. The number we're doing right now is, I'm really pumped about that. It's looking awesome. There are a lot of really cool people in the cast that I'm just getting to know. Akshay, he's insane. Wait till you see this kid dance. And it's not the way he dances that's amazing, it's the driving force and the art that goes along with it. I love that kid. Ladies, one word, one legend, one man, Akshay. Well,
I feel like you gotta know what my roles are before I answer this question. I am Ensemble. I'm the Black Knight, and I'm Prince Herbert. I gotta say, this one role I'm really hyped for. It's gotta be Prince Herbert. Shout out to my gay buddy Nikki. We used to be gay together. Gonna love it. I also get my legs and arms cut off. Vinny, why don't you talk about what you do?
I'm not gay.
Who's the coolest male in the world?
Coolest or like most attractive?
Oh my gosh. Both.
Definitely Akshay. I'm gonna have to go with Akshay. Just because he's got like that chocolate glove.
Akshay.
Akshay, without a doubt.
Oh, Akshay Rajaram, man. It's the hair. Oh, no, it's not just the hair.
That's all I gotta say.
I'm a French taunter, and I'm also Brother Maynard, he's a priest. And most interesting part that I do, or the most interesting part of the play?
Both.
Just your favorite
part. I think the French taunters are fun. And most interesting part of the play is probably the You Won't Succeed on Broadway if you don't have any Jews song. I love that song.
I mean, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of organizing and lots of emails back and forth. Like, basically, my main job is that I watch rehearsals and I figure out what's going on. And I do all the organizing, like telling what kind of props we need and what we covered in the rehearsal and any kind of production info that Mr. Brown or any of the other like directors need.
So like a hairline fracture? Oh no, it's like broken.
She can't put any weight on it.
Okay.
So we have to call the orthopedist to get a boot.
Okay. Right. That's what we're gonna have to figure it out.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll talk to Stephen and Brown and we'll see if we can do it. How are you feeling otherwise?
Okay. Fine.
Fine?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. You suffer for your art.
Hi, well, basically last Saturday, during You Can't Succeed on Broadway, I fell and then someone fell on my foot and it was like a big catastrophe. And so basically I fractured one of my metatarsals and dislocated something. And so that's how that's going. I'm in a cast right now, so I won't be able to do most of the show, but I can still do my guard thing and I'll still be in Lancelot, so that's good. I think right now we're gearing up to do the finale, so I'm gonna come out as a Laker girl at the end. Woo!
Woo!
And that's Shannon.
Did you ever see that episode of The Cosby Show where Cliff and Claire had a fashion show and everyone thought that Claire was gonna lose because she was in a boot and they just bedazzled the hell out of the boot and she beat them?
I'm way too old, Mr. Brown.
I'm thinking bedazzled guard from the Who's on First Bench.
Can we still play the guard?
I think so.
If I can find like an old timey crutch.
I'm getting a walking boot this week.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll feel like I'll still be able to walk.
Okay.
We could possibly put a crutch on the back of the giant axe that you have in that scene. And so, okay, I'm not serious. Don't look at me like that, all right? We'll just re-block the fall, because your fall will probably be really authentic now.
Or that.
Yeah. I mean, slow and comical, it definitely will be.
You'll just have to go off and dance.
Right, yeah. But I take my axe thing off at the end of that scene anyway, so.
Oh, okay.
Good.
That's really the only thing you can do, right? Can't do any of the Laker girls.
Yeah, probably not.
Oh boy. When did it happen?
Yesterday during.
Was it during a dance?
It was during the Kansas City Broadway, but it wasn't on stage.
Oh really?
Yeah.
She ran into quick.
Like you know when the Star of David girls do the booty train?
Yeah.
On stage. I wasn't looking and like I tripped over someone and then like someone else like.
I mean, it's right backstage and we had a lot of space learning, so it's hardly anyone's fault.
Okay.
This is a learning experience that happens to
every
cause
year,
a lot of pain.
Yeah, every year we need a fallen soldier. It's you this year. okay, well, when do you want to, when are you getting the boot?
I don't know, sometime this week.
Okay. Are you staying the rest of the day? I want to figure out like how to reblock the scene.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I can. Yeah.
We can do it today, or we can do it sometime this week. Just, I'll just need you probably in the gang.
Okay.
Yeah, if you're here, maybe if we have time, we'll do it today.
Okay.
And if there's anything else, like if there's any part of any other scene that you're in for this or that that you feel like you could still do, let us know. Cause you're on like 90% of the show. In
I was
going
to say, we
want
to be able to put you on as much as we can. So
while you can't maybe do the booty train of Star of David anymore.
At least you're wearing a
which
mic.
Which may
and
be
you
a sign.
Sing?
Yeah.
A sing?
Yeah, you can
we could plant you somewhere else on stage and you could sing and just do movements from the top up, you know?
If there were a running joke, like you were just sort of popped up above the parapets in the top and went back and forth like in a shooting gallery. I mean, I'm just spitballing right now. But I'm saying, we want to leave as many options for you open. You've put in a little time, so we figured we'll do something for you there. Oh, good Lord. Okay, well, now that it is awkward, I'm going to walk away. And if you need anything, you know where I work.
I missed the beginning. Is it broken?
Yeah.
How much time?
6 weeks.
Dang. Did you still go to the middle school show last night?
Yeah.
On your broken ankle?
Yeah.
It was a good show?
Yeah, it was cute. It was really cute.
Good job.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah.
Your sister should love you for that. Hobbling in, scotch tape around an ankle, see you.
I didn't even tape it, I just had a sock.
Wasn't even tape, that's how tough she is.
No, that's just how much of an idiot I am.
Okay, you're asking the wrong guy. Okay, I'm sorry you spent all of your manliness growing upward and then on your beard.
It's a sad life.
Hey, I couldn't do it at your age, man. It was fine. It's like, no shame. I don't know.
I'll ask.
Anyone have like a back hair transplant to the gas? Who's got some hair? Vinny, do you have spare hair on your body you can shave off and tape on his face? You need something. There are ways to do it, and I will, you know what? Have you asked Ms. Flanagan?
I talked to some of the costume guys.
Yeah, don't you talk to the costume. They're not designed to make such executive. I'm going to go look for some testosterone for you to get that beard growing. Hold on 1 second.
I'm going to have a beard. I'm going to get a good beard.
Yeah.
We're having this discussion now, by the way.
As long as we get, like...
Is that your Frenchie outfit?
I have no idea.
Yes, I need to have a Frenchie outfit. I'm so excited.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Baggage.
Alex.
Yes. All right. Here's the deal with the beard.
Alex or am I King
Arthur? You're Alex. Okay. Because King Arthur would have grown his beard already.
And
you're
no.
Alex. Okay. Outside of the creative staff that suggested puberty, the second solution was you need to be aware because McGraw has worn fake beards on stage. And because you sweat so much, it requires application and reapplication of spirit gum, and it's going to just wreak havoc on your skin, and every time you're on stage, you're going to have to be glued up and stuck and so forth and so on beyond the mic issues that it's going to create. So keep that in mind when I hit you with the follow-up information of it's not approaching the list of priorities yet. Until we can successfully stab an armless, legless knight through the heart with a sword and have it talk to us and that goes off well, and until all of those showgirls out there that are currently essentially topless cannot be topless because that's not something we want to promote here, then it could raise on the priority list, all right? So
totally okay.
So we've planted that seed,
all right?
All right? We're going to cultivate it at will.
Whatever you guys think is best.
I'm fine with it. High school show, if someone complains about that, I'll give them a refund. But if they do, I'm sad for the role they play in life, all right?
Excuse me, Mr. Round.
I would not recommend gluing anything to your face. I don't think it'll make you happy. I mean...
It's like we didn't want Abby to like color her hair for Legally Blonde, would make it all fall out at the end. That kid doesn't take care of her hair. All right, that's that. Cool. Lauren Dillon, she's next.
The student technical director?
Yes.
Basically, I provide any technical support throughout the whole play, where needed, I guess you would say. Wherever needed, I'm there. I can do it.
Are there any difficult people?
Probably Mr. Brown.
Mr. Brown?
Yeah, he's the hardest to work with.
Any comment on?
Can you expand on that?
Any stories?
Let me think of one. He's just a pain to work with. I mean, he nags me all the time. He doesn't let me. That's not even. I'm trying to think of something that would really piss him off. Yes.
Do you think McGraw's scary?
I feel like he's a burnt marshmallow. Like a really crusty marshmallow. It's black. It's like all crusty and black on the outside, but nice and gooey and soft on the inside. But you gotta find that gooey center. It's hard to find that. I still haven't found it yet.
Well, being the director of the show, it's one of those things where you have to... It's kind of a multi-layered job. So the first step is obviously kind of getting a feel for the show, interpreting the script, thinking about demands of the production in from a technical standpoint, and then thinking about casting requirements. Like, you know, honestly, one of the biggest questions is, do we have the talent to pull off a particular show? And because we think about our talent pool in the school and stuff like that. And then there's, you know, sort of planning stages of meetings with your production team, like, you know, your set builder and your set designer and your painter and your costume designer. So, you know, a director kind of develops a vision for a show, and then you have to sort of align all of the areas to make sure that they, as best they can, and under the constraints of, you know, time and materials and all of that considered, to execute that vision. So it's kind of a very heady job. Like, a lot of my work actually takes place up here before, you know, I even kind of like start the rehearsal process. Breathe in and out. Sorry for the breath. Breathe in and out. Mwah!
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 Bah! Okay, this is a biggie. Make sure you have your own space. Repeat after me, and do what I do. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10!
I'm probably gonna wear some sexy ass pants. Probably gonna like dance my booty off. Probably gonna do a lot of clapping. You know? Honestly, I'll probably just look hot.
It's all a show, happy ending and all, and that just makes me want.
But like, I'm probably just gonna look hot. That's probably all we're gonna do today. We're just gonna make me look hot. Like, I don't know what else we would do. So yeah, okay, see ya.
And you feel doomed to fail. Do not fail. Find your mail. Find your mail, that's your grail.
Just think, Herbert, in 1,000 years' time, this will still be controversial.
I think for me, one of the most difficult parts was figuring out how our schedules can work together. Since I come from about an hour away and I have a sort of unconventional schedule that doesn't really match up with the school day schedule, it was difficult to figure out when it could work, but I think we got it to work and we finished everything and it looks great. And something else that was difficult this week actually was when Lainey broke her foot and she was in the wheelchair. So figuring out how to incorporate her into the dances still was a little bit challenging, but I think it'll add some humor to the show and I think it'll be funny.
I am the student costume director and in charge of hair and makeup as well. And so I personally help with all of the costumes and hair and makeup, and I also direct other students to do that.
Okay. What costume are you most excited about making for the musical?
Anything for the Lady of the Lake. She has a striptease, she is a fab diva, lots of glitter, lots of sequins, lots of revealing clothing.
Well, we open Spamalot tomorrow night, so we have one rehearsal to finally tune what it is going to be for y'all, the hashtag audience.
How do you feel about that?
I feel very good, prepared, good.
Do you, anything in particular you're looking forward to?
Performing, mostly.
Can you elaborate?
Performing musically. I think we're done here. Cut.
Supreme executive power just because I'm already taught through a sword at you.
Can't.
Fall around sound of empty. Just because some moistened bint had loved a scimitar at me. They put
him
away.
Oh.
Soggy old blondes with the backsides of pawns cannot replace the electorate.
Damn straight.
So yeah, should we not get beards?
What are we talking about?
Because we're the manliest of the night.
This is
of the round table.
Literally what I will aspire to be in like 20 years.
It's the
this beard.
It's the
like,
lumberjack beard.
It's all I want in my life. Like, I got it all. Except for this.
With the beard.
Except for this. And I, so it's just, even if it's fake, it's nice to pretend.
I 100% agree. I mean, like, all I want is a beard in life, really, and like.
One day you'll grow one. You just have to hit puberty first.
Right.
Yeah.
Then it'll happen.
Schmidt, let's go.
These guys.
Oh.
Come on.
That's Nikki.
He's one of our beardless friends. That's what we refer to them as. Beardless.
Look.
Like the beardless.
Look at
like
a people on the
I got,
hair.
I have hair. It's real. It's real.
Yeah.
Whoa. Pre-game, no shave. No shave November. No shave March because I'm superstitious. Suck it, patience. We need to go with Tebow.
You have the fantastic makeup.
Why are you
woman
going
that puts on my beard.
Last time we didn't get to with everyone, and everyone's in the dressing room right now. I made sure
she stares in my face for like a solid 5 minutes and puts on a beard.
Now, that's all I gotta say.
No, because
read my book later.
All right, we gotta go pray to Tebow.
Yeah, we're gonna go pray to Tebow.
Not me, because I'm not
shout
a guy.
Shout out Tebow, you're gonna be on the Eagles soon.
No, I mean, she hasn't had puberty yet, so.
Oh. Yes, I have. No, he hasn't.
Nick, you just made that insult about you.
Final Andy. He's at puberty, I'm not in. Get out of here, Alan. He's at puberty, I'm not. No, we have. Everyone's here. And last night, we didn't know what to do, they called places. Let's go. 20. 20.
Go outside.
20.
Go until I have
20.
We never have time.
Yeah.
Well, we won't have time. And they literally just said 20. Just do it now.
20? It's 6:40.
Yeah, until both of our warm-ups. Can we just... come on.
There's actually 20 to warm-ups.
Fine.
We do
come
it
on
after warm-ups.
Come on.
Talk to Ben.
Ben.
I'm not the one who does
Ben,
it.
Ben, Tebow now. Seth, it's 6:40, but everyone's here now, and yesterday we only had like 5 people, and that ain't cool.
No, no, it's right before, though.
Tebow is always like the last thing you do, like right before you go on.
Right. Alright, well, if everyone's
everyone
in
book
here,
it out,
what are we doing?
When
everyone's, since everyone's in here now. Hey, Vinny!
Vinny!
No. In the style of Tebow, pull out at the last minute.
Yo, Tebow's supposed to go to the Eagles.
Shut the fuck up, come true. This show is nowhere near complete. We have one of the biggest crowds we're ever gonna have out there tonight.
Yeah!
Yeah! I want to remain as focused and as intelligent as the amazing people I know you all are. We're gonna get out there and we're gonna do a hell of a job once again. Can I get a
Thank you. Just pull up your pants. You have it. If I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it.
Benjamin Ross.
Yeah. I'll just find the outfit. Just hold it.
Hey. Does it matter which room we do?
Good evening, Tebow. Thank you for an awesome show yesterday. But I think your titties can give us leading a little more power today for tonight's show. We need it. We need them Tebow titties. And I can't believe I just need to throw this one out there. Tebow, more like T-blow your J.
That's what I like. That's
yes.
All
right. Yes. Yes.
All right, Ateeb.
Ateeb!
Let's get this shit.
Oh, I need to piss.
That was the
can I piss right here? No. Holy shit, what the fuck?
Yeah, but...
What? Looking back in the show, it was definitely a lot of fun and surprisingly seamless for such a complicated show, and definitely just something to be proud of. There's nothing to it other than good feelings.
I got to step into a leadership role with this show because I was dance captain, so I think that tested my ability as a leader, so I think I grew in that respect a little bit. And then I also got to spend more time with my friends this show than I ever have before, and I think I grew in that I got to appreciate their company more with this show than I ever have before, so.
It's like bittersweet because I've had such a great time and I'm gonna love to look back on that. But I'm also not gonna get to do it again, which is really sad. But I'm hoping that I can like take some of the things that I learned here and maybe like continue in college and keep doing it, because this theater department was really good and it really helped me to realize how much I loved doing theater. So it kind of inspired me to wanna go and keep doing it in the future. So this is gonna be weird seeing my first Downingtown East musical next year. It was a good experience. I really enjoyed all four shows that I've been in. I really enjoyed every minute of it.
It's kind of a hard question because, well, I guess not really. I've had issues with friends and having to pick between friend groups. Like, my friends would be like, why are you hanging out with all those theater kids? They're so weird. And I'm like, well, I'm weird. So it kind of made me pick the people I wanted to be with more. I mean, of course I had to be at rehearsal, but I wanted to be at rehearsal too. So it was kind of, I found myself more in the show having to make the decision rather than, oh, I can do both at the same time when I really couldn't. So I got to pick a side, so I kind of found myself in this year.
It's definitely made me a lot more open and a lot less awkward and shy, because middle school I was very closed shell, but now I really don't care what people think of me.
Never let someone determine your talent. Like, other people's opinions don't matter because it's just an opinion.
Definitely like the friendships that you make. Like Emily, she's was the ASM this year, and we met freshman year, and we hadn't known each other at all before that, and now we're really close and we have lots of inside jokes and that kind of thing, and that goes for a lot of different people throughout the process.
Friendships between all our stage crew, family. We have this weird family and it was really fun. So just my stage crew friendships in general is just amazing.
Definitely the friendships. The friendships are the best thing I got out of this because it's like a family and I'm gonna miss them so much.
I'm gonna take away a big sense of community. I'm gonna leave with these friendships that I made in freshman year, still intact, and probably for a long time. And I wouldn't have had that playing sport or something like that. This is a sense of spending every day, all year with the same people. Cause we have the fall shows and we have the musicals and we have our theater club and everything like that. And it's all the same kind of group of people. And having those friends through all of high school and probably beyond is gonna be the biggest thing that I'm gonna take away from this.
Take away from my entire theater experience, I would probably choose to stay involved in the things that make your life worth living, and don't trade that for anything, because there are definitely times when I was like, I'm so stressed with school, I should not do the musical, but that would have been a terrible, terrible mistake, because it's such a source of happiness, and I hope to stick with it.